We're here today to talk about RTA's new program intended to encourage juveniles to pay their appropriate fare. It's a program that the Board of Trustees of the Greater Cleveland Transit Authority approved to start on February 1st. It's called the Juvenile Fare Violation Program. I'm Mary McCann, RTA's Media Relations Manager, and with me to explain more about the program is Deputy Chief Lamont Lockhart of RTA's Transit Police. Welcome, Deputy Chief.
Thanks
for being here. Before we talk about the specifics of the juvenile violation fare, let's give a little background about the proof of payment system. What is it and where is it used throughout the RTA?
Our proof of payment system is used only on the helpline and the red line. The helpline is our bus rapid transit system that travels from downtown Cleveland to Euclid Avenue all the way to East Cleveland. The red line goes all the way from East Cleveland to the airport, and that is our most ridden train line. In total, 18% of customers use both red line and helpline services. In order to speed up the process of boarding the train, proof of payment means people have to buy their tickets off board, meaning that the fare vending machines along the helpline and red line at Tower City, online at www.riderta.com, or at one of the dozens of vendors like Giant Eagle, Dave's Supermarkets, Discount Drug Mart, and more around the region. By buying a ticket in advance, it avoids the lines you see on a typical bus. By not having a line, passengers get to their destinations quicker than waiting in line. Each rider is expected to pay the appropriate fare, adults and juveniles.
So how could kids or anyone get away with not paying their fare?
Because people buy their tickets off the vehicle and the operators are focusing on safety, it is the job of the transit police to do checks on the red line and helpline for fare enforcement.
So how exactly does that work? How do transit police officers check that people are paying their fares on the helpline or red line?
We have 50 part-time officers that are on staff who are designated fare enforcement officers. They patrol the red line and the helpline throughout the day and night when the system is in operation.
Do transit police officers ticket adults for fare violation?
Actually, yes, we give tickets to adults. Adults get a notice to appear in court, and the courts determine their fees. That money collected goes to the city of Cleveland. The new juvenile ticketing system has penalties for kids who don't pay their fares, with steps in place to help them avoid the court system.
When transit police officers get on a vehicle, how exactly do they do those checks?
There are two fare enforcement officers that travel together. When they get on the vehicle, they make an announcement to the passengers that they are checking for tickets. This could be a monthly pass, a five-trip pass, an all-day pass, a one-ride pass, or a student pass, among other options. The officers check every person on that car, on the red line or on the helpline vehicle. This is the method officers use every day on the proof of payment system. It is important that every person pay the appropriate fare.
So let's get back to the juvenile specific issue. Tell me exactly how this new juvenile ticket will work, Deputy Chief.
Starting February 1st, we'll give a warning and it'll be given to the juvenile at that time. A warning is also sent to the home address to the parents. If stopped again and already warned previously, they'll be given a ticket for $50, given to the juvenile and sent home to the parent, and they'll have 30 days to pay. If a ticket is paid, no further action is needed. If a ticket is not paid, the juvenile goes to the diversion program. And if the diversion program is completed, some sort of community service normally, that's it. If the diversion program is not completed, the juvenile is sent to court. The court then determines punishment. If the juvenile gets caught again, they get another ticket for $50 and start the process again.
So what is the actual age of a juvenile?
17 and under.
I would think this is a common sense question, but because there are so many juveniles the police find not paying to ride, tell me about how kids can avoid getting tickets.
It's very simple. Pay their fare, just like we require of all our customers. Kids must purchase their pass at a fare machine located at each helpline or red line station. They can also buy them at the other vendors we mentioned before, like Giant Eagle, Discount Drug Mart, and Dave's Supermarkets. If students have a pass from their school or that they previously purchased, they must validate it at the machines when they are ready to ride. This is a simple process. It's done by simply inserting the ticket into the machine and pressing validate.
I know that officers often find adults with student tickets. Are adults able to use student tickets?
No, absolutely not. Since some schools give their kids passes, they think they can sell the passes to adults for some extra money. But the adults can't legally use them. Many of the adults we cite for fare evasion have student tickets they are trying to use. Simply put, every customer needs to pay his or her fare, whether an adult or juvenile.
Why is the RTA adding this juvenile ticket to its system?
Our fare enforcement officers on the Helpline and the Red Line, the two systems that use the off-board fare collection we're discussing, found that about one-third of the people they were stopping were under 18. We tried to find a system that gave kids the benefit of the doubt and helped them avoid the court system.
What if parents, school administrators, or juveniles themselves have additional questions about the tickets and the procedures?
They can always call the RTA answer line at 216-621-9500, or they can visit our website for more information at www.riderta.com.
Thank you, Chief. We appreciate the information.
Thank you.
We're doing our best to educate our customers and their families on the rules of riding RTA and the penalties for not following those rules. The juvenile fare ticket process will begin February 1st.